Hi everyone, I will explain about the design of FIR and IIR filter to filter the noise audio given to home group 1 by using Scilab. This is the coding on comparison between noise audio and clean audio, and we should apply the filter onto the noise audio to get desired clean audio.
0125.
As we listen, this is the noise audio. We can see that from this frequency plotting, the noise frequency is roughly from 0 to 0.85 kHz and 4.8 kHz to 7 kHz. T is from 0 second to 2.12 second. The sampling frequency is 8 kHz. Then we shall design a FIR filter. We can take a look at the windowing method, which is to compute desired filter function into impulse response, Hn. For this FIR design, the specifications are bandpass filter, filter order 250 by using Hamming window method. This 0.05 is obtained because of low cutoff frequency 850 Hz divided by sampling frequency 8.5 kHz. Then due to its symmetric effect, we divide by 2 again. The 0.282 is due to the high cutoff frequency, which is 4.8 kHz and same calculations as previous. Zeck transform is also being applied here to convert discrete signal Hn to a complex Zeck plan. We can see that from here, window 1, this is the impulse response from the Hamming window. And with the use of FFT function, we can obtain the magnitude response for FIR filter, and this is the phase response of the filter in dB. This figure 4 here shows the Zeck transform of the filter. Convolution is a process of filtering noise signal with the design filter. Hence, it can output the impulse response for clean signal. We convolve the FIR coefficient Hn with the original audio signal Y. Then apply Fourier transform and observe all the signals in time domain and frequency domain. From the audio, we can know that most of the noise has been filtered, proving the FIR filter is working. Furthermore, from this plot window, the first row is the noise signal, middle row is the FIR filter signal, and the last row are clean signals. Then we shall take a look into the IIR filter design. The specifications are bandpass filter, Butterworth approximation, filter order 10, and cutoff frequency parameter are the same as FIR filter, which are 0.05 to 0.282. We first apply the built-in IIR function with the specification. Then we use frequency and magnitude function to obtain the magnitude of IIR filter. Next, we transform the Hzeck from Zeck transform to time response function by using FLTS function, followed by Fourier transform function and absolute function. Then we can obtain the filter audio by using inverse Fourier transform.
0125.
From the audio, we can know that most of the noise have been filtered, proving the IIR filter is working. This first figure shows the signal comparison before and after the filtering process in both time and frequency domain. The second figure shows the Zeck plan, and the third figure is the magnitude response of this IIR filter, whereas the fourth figure is the phase response of this IIR filter in dB. For bilinear transformation, it can be used to get the filter coefficient for desired IIR filter function. Hence, from this coding, we can get the poles and zero from the built-in IIR function based on our specification. Most importantly, we should get PL, poles, ZR, zeros, and gain for this filter. Then from here, we can use the coding to get back the values and start to generate back the IIR filter based on the poles, zeros, and gain. We use linear system function to compute the system function in terms of Hz1, and use frequency magnitude function to get back its magnitude and phase spectrum. Then we run it.
0125.
Most of the noise have been filtered, proving that this IIR filter by linear transformation is working. That's all from me. Thank you.